What was she doing? Where was she? What was she wearing? What did she say? How did she act?
Blame the woman for being irresponsibly leaving her house at, you know, a later hour.
Well, why did you go to the market alone? Why did you not cover yourself up properly?
To share your story with me.
اب میں پہلے تو یہ حیران ہوں کہ تین بچوں کی ماں ہے, اکیلی ڈرائیور ہے. آپ سیدھا روڈ لو, جی ٹی روڈ جہاں پہ آپ آتی ہے, اور گھر چلی جاؤ. کم از کم اپنے پیٹرول چیک کر لو, کیونکہ اس سائے پیٹرول پمپ نہیں ہوتے.
Victims are blamed, they are shamed. The location will be blamed, the time will be blamed. It's language that we use, it's how we talk about victims, it's how we talk to victims. So all of that creates a culture which enables rape. I myself have been through sexual harassment very early on in my career. And my family also does not want me to name my harasser, because they're like, you know, we're not ready for that kind of shaming.
Our fears are coming to life before us, which made us feel like, if this does happen to me, which there is a high chance of happening, then I will be blamed for it. So it's a highly manipulative patriarchal tool to stop the vulnerable from holding the privilege accountable.
The past 4-5 days, the cases of online abuse from men have really, really spiraled and skyrocketed, because they don't like the discourse that we are putting forward, which is that all men are complicit in this and the entirety of society is complicit in this. So when they don't like that discourse, they attack you.
Born in, say, Pakistan, you somehow grow up in an environment where people keep telling you, tum ladki ho to dupatta le lo, bazaar ja rahi ho to kameez pehen lo. But as we've grown up and with the advent of social media, it's finally come the realization of, no, this cannot be acceptable, because now the younger generation realizes, hum jab chahe jo chahe hum bhi kar sakte hain, aur aapko hifazat. کیا آپ 12 بجے کے بعد آپ حفاظت کیا ختم ہو جاتی ہے اس ملک میں ہماری.
If we talk about rape culture, I think it's when we think that a woman is an object of honor that must be safeguarded at all times. Because I think this perception that people think that women on roads can, you know, become independent and they are a threat to this patriarchal system. We need to, you know, engage people in this. So if we do unite towards a cause, if we do talk about stuff, and if we do come together, there will be consequences, there will be change.